Assalamu alaikum everybody, this is your brother Sam and a very warm welcome back to the Sam of Somalia channel. We've got a really nice video today. It was just Somali language video. So it was submitted, the idea was actually submitted by a sister called Noura Hussein. So thank you very much for that, sister. Just a really interesting list of words. She actually gave me about 20, but I'm only going to share about 5 with you. Words that in Somali, if you just add an extra vowel, it completely changes the meaning. So we're going to run through them and just talk about them as we go, inshallah. So that's coming up right after we thank our sponsors. I'll see you in a minute. I'm sure all of you have some sort of dream of becoming fluent in another language and getting to enjoy all of the benefits that it can bring, whether that's work opportunities, opportunities to travel, or if it's like me and you just want a chance to sweet talk the in-laws. But there's a simple fact about learning a new language, and that's that you need real human, real contact time to practice and to drill your new language. You may be able to learn a ton of grammar and language concepts from resources online and books you can get on Amazon, but real fluency demands real human contact. iTalki is a website and an app which is teeming with supportive teachers, where you can get the guidance that you need tailored to your learning needs. On iTalki, a whole bunch of people, in fact, over 3 million people, are learning languages to a level of fluency with quality and effective teachers who are also native speakers. As you can see, there are over 100 languages available, including English, Spanish, Italian, Chinese, Russian, and much, much more. Not only does iTalki have over 5,000 teachers ready and waiting for you, but it's affordable, so you don't need an enormous budget to reach your language learning goals.
To get $10 free credit after you buy your first lesson on iTalki, click the link in the description below.
So firstly, right, we've got the word, well, it's, obviously two words. And the thing is, that's really good about this, the reason why I wanted to do this video on this channel is because I've made all these mistakes, I think, in one or two videos that I've done before. And people have often corrected me in the comments, have been like, Sam, it's not C, it's C, or it's not Dib, it's Dib. Yeah, so we're going to go through some of those differences. So the first one, right, is Dib and Dib. The verb dib with two i's in it is to give someone. You know, if you say idib, it means give it to me. But a dib is a problem, you know, dib. So those are two completely different words. Yeah, dib meaning give, or dib is a problem. Next one, as I said, is si and si. So si means like, you know, two things are similar, you know, si. But si with the two i's in it, a bit like the verb dib, means to give someone. So si actually means the same thing. It's just a coincidence that they're both close sounding words, something which means something completely different. So you can say e si just as you can say e dib. I don't know what the difference is. You know, if any of you guys do know in Somali what the difference is between the verb si and dib, let me know in the comments below for other Somali language learning beginners as well, so they can know too. Next one. Okay, we have the verb qor, which means to write. Qor. And then the word for a neck, which is qar. So they're very close. The only difference is adding an extra vowel in there. Qor, meaning to write. Qar, which means a neck. I don't know if I've made that mistake on the channel before. Qor. And I think when you use qor as a verb, it's qorin. You say qorinaya. Wahan qorinaya, I'm writing. Wahan qorinaya. You don't just say qoraya. It's one of those verbs that you add in on the end. Wahan qorinaya, I am writing. Next one, the verb dar. Dar, the reason why I chose this one to be one that I mentioned is because recently in a video about Somali words that you need for Eid, some people said like dar, dar Eid. You know, that's like your Eid clothes. Yeah, dar, dar Eid. It was also what was mentioned by a few of you guys is haqqul Eid. Haqqul Eid is like the right of Eid. It's like, give me money, basically. It's what the kids will say, haqqul Eid. But anyway, dar means clothes, but dar is a promise. You know, so two very different things. Dar meaning clothes, and then dar with an extra vowel and an extra A is a promise. Last one. This sounds a lot like my surname. Bur. Bur, just bur alone means flour, not like a flour that would grow in the garden, but flour as in that you make bread with, I think. But then bur, so there's bur, which means flour, and then bur with an extra U in there, which means a mountain. So yeah, bur and bur. So just one last time, just to run through them, obviously 5 examples of words in Somali that meaning changes drastically if you just add an extra vowel. So firstly, we started with dib and dib, si, and C, then we did qor and qar, then we did dar and dar, and then lastly we did bur and bur. So that's everything from this video. As I said, I did kind of have a question of the day for you guys, that if you can explain the difference between deeb and see, then please put it in the comments below. And I look forward to seeing what you guys put down there. If you enjoyed this video, as always, and I really hope you did, don't forget to like and share it. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Don't forget to hit the bell as well, or else you'll never get notifications ever again. And you'll never see my face ever again. So make sure you do that. And I look forward to seeing you guys in the next one. Take it easy. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.